What's up, everybody? Ian here from redlinestands.com. And about a week or two ago, I promised you guys I was going to do a review video of my foam PA or engine block, and today is that day. So a lot of folks don't know it, that there's a company out there called PAer that is making these foam engines that you see in my car. The reason for that is because when you're building one of these old cars and you're trying to get everything mocked up and figure out where everything's going to go, how it's going to line the whole nine yards, it is way too much of a pain to take that actual legitimate engine over there and start putting it in and out and in and out and in and out of the car as you get everything lined up. Way too much trouble. So the people at PAer have made that a whole lot easier with their fake engines. What makes these blocks so great is that you've got all of the little threaded inserts in everything just like you would in the real thing, so you can totally build the entire car without all the hassle of dealing with the weight of the real thing. I feel like this is probably a good time to tell you guys that we get this question a lot as a dealer for PAer. People contact us and they want to know whether or not PAer is going to make an engine block for their car, and it'll be obscure stuff like a Bentley Mulsanne or a Tucker or whatever it may be. And the answer to that is no. Each one of those first blocks that they produce, the mold for one of those blocks, I'm told, costs about $30,000 per mold. And not just that, you've got to have a team of attorneys working for like a year or two with the original manufacturer to get all of the rights to actually reproduce that copy. So if you're looking for a block, head, transmission, whatever, and you don't see it on our website, it's probably not being made, and it's probably not going to get made anytime soon. I know that PAer is coming out with a Coyote here soon, a Ford Coyote block, so keep an eye out for that. But if you guys are looking for anything obscure at all, just know in advance, they're probably not going to make those kind of requests. In the case of building my car, I had a lot of things that I really didn't know if they were going to fit the way that I wanted them to or not. I didn't know if my headers were going to go around my upper control arms and actually fit, whether or not there was going to be room for the steering. Underneath the block, I didn't really know if there was going to be enough room to use a stock oil pan that was going to, you know, fit and clear around the cross member. What my pinion angle was going to be when I try and line up my transmission to my differential. So all of these kinds of things, as you're trying to get your engine in your car and get everything set up, are terribly important. And this is where the block comes in and makes it so handy, because this thing is actually a molded replica of a real block. With that said, let's go ahead and get this block out of the car and have an up close look and see what kind of a job PAer really did. Before we talk about the block, quick shout out to the folks at CPP who make these sliding LS engine mounts. Thought those things were really cool, nice fabrication. Of course, they bolt right up to my PAer block here, just like it would a normal block. So first, just to give you an idea of what these things weigh, man, I don't know, this cylinder head, less than 5 pounds, 2 or 3 maybe. The engine block with these motor mounts installed, I'm going to say with the motor mounts, it's 15 to 20 pounds. So before, when I said that these things were reproductions of the original, if we kind of get in close, you can see what I mean. There's spark plug holes, threaded inserts, everything. They are exactly the same as the original. Everything is, just a perfect representation, literally made from a mold. It's what you want. So I've heard about these foam engine blocks, and like you, I tend to think of foam as being something that's really, really easy, you know, to break with your hands and whatnot. So if I come up on a ladder and I'm having a look here at the spray foam inside of my shop, you know, this stuff is really, really pliable, very, very easy to break it, right? These PAer engine blocks are not what you're thinking. It's not that type of foam. So to try and give you an idea of exactly what this foam is like, suppose for a second that I were to take a little claw hammer, and let me hit this halfway decent. You know, you might be able to see that I've I've kind of put an ever so slight dent into the surface there, but at the end of the day, you can see what I mean in that it's not just pushing right through it in the way that you would expect out of traditional foam. Let me try it here with the claw in and see what happens. All right, so there I'm actually finally starting to put some divots into the foam. Nothing major, but nonetheless, you kind of get what I'm talking about here. This stuff is a lot more rigid and stronger than what you're thinking. I've always kind of wondered, these little threaded metal inserts that you see in these blocks, just kind of curious, you know, how strong are those things really held in place? You know, would they break easy or whatnot? So since I've got one of these blocks here, I'm tempted just to test and see. I've got a receiver hitch here. You guys probably have a good idea of about what a receiver hitch weighs. It's not light. You can take this thing and just hang it right off the front of the block, and you don't hear any cracking or see any twisting or anything. It's pretty strong. Would like to take this chance to say thank you to the folks at PAer for sponsoring my build with this block. We have been a dealer for those folks for the better part of the last decade, selling engine blocks for them, so it's not the kind of thing that they do for everybody, so thanks to PAer for sponsoring the build. In the near future, keep an eye out. I'm going to be doing a little review video on the Norco engine load leveler. They make some really nice lifting equipment. We've been selling their stuff for probably a decade or so. It's not the cheapest thing out there, but in terms of quality, they're definitely in the upper echelon. Got that video coming out probably within the next week or two. So there you go. That is PAer's foam engine block. Of course, I got the LS model. They've got those things in all the real common stuff. Big block Chevy, I think 302 Ford, you know, 426 Hemi, the list just goes on and on for the common stuff. Check them out on our website, redlinestands.com. Give us a shout if you got questions. Hope y'all enjoyed this. Please click the thumbs up down below. That really helps the YouTube algorithm put us towards the top so that we get a little bit more exposure. I appreciate that. If you guys want to see some more videos of us here at Redline, click to subscribe. Hope y'all enjoyed it. Have a good one. Take care.